Hello guys, so today is Sunday 4th June 2017 and this is a Scania G450 from 2016 or so. It's gone 130,000 kilometers right now. Really good condition. I love these luxury Scanias. And this is just gonna be a calm, relaxing video. I'm not gonna talk too much, I think. So make sure you got some good speakers or headphones and just enjoy the driving. And don't forget to leave a like and comment and subscribe and share if you want on your social page. Also, to support me, don't forget to check out the ads and stuff. Got low pressure there. Look at those. So, I'm gonna put on the GPS here. Jordbro! I'm just gonna record as long as the GoPro is gonna record. I've got low battery, so we'll see how long it will record. Nice bike, man. Holy crap. Very nice bike. Right now it's 17 o'clock, by the way. Now in Täby, Arninge, which is north of Stockholm, Sweden. drops into neutral here by itself, echo rolling. These newer Scanias does that, you know. So now we're in 75, rolling up to 80 again here, and I'm gonna enable the cruise control, putting it here to 80, and it does got this camera sensor here as well. So let's turn that on, and let's set the distance here. So now it can brake automatically if there's a car that's going slowly. Yeah, on that Volvo FH, I had to put it on the ACC for the camera cruise control to work, which I had no clue of. Pretty complicated truck that is. The new Volvos, new generation kind of. Be nice. nice now to come back to the terminal and eat some food and empty the truck and trailer and then just relax. Maybe I'll load up the combination. We'll see. Today I quit a little bit earlier. I started work 12 o'clock. So I'll quit 9 o'clock in the evening. Fuel consumption is pretty good actually. Let's see here, I think it's like 3.5 to 4 liters every 10 kilometers. Yeah, very good fuel consumption. Got a crack coming here though. Many of you are wondering about the cracks, and from what I've read on a comment, and which I know also is true, is that first you get a stone that hits. So it starts off with a little stone hit, and then as you pass other trucks in like country roads and stuff, such a huge wind coming, which then makes the crack wander every time you pass a truck and the wind slams onto the windshield. Then the crack wanders about, and usually they always wander like right underneath your visibility spot, so usually they're fine for the inspection, it's no problem. As long as it's not blocking your view, I heard that it's legal with windshield cracks, at least in Sweden. Which is good, because otherwise you would have to change windshield all the freaking time, as they break so often. Breaking all the time, this guy. Let's just overtake him, man. He seems weird. I don't trust him, and I'm not driving behind him.